साईराम स्टूडेंट्स, चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस आवर फर्स्ट सबमिटिव असेसमेंट। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द पेपर पैटर्न एंड देन वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज। चिल्ड्रन, द पोर्शन फॉर एसे वन इज लेसन नंबर 1, 2, 3 एंड 4। आई होप यू हैव ऑल स्टार्टेड स्टडिंग एंड गोइंग थ्रू ऑल द चैप्टर्स। The total marks for the exam is 40 marks. It will be all objective type questions. Okay, you have to go through the question and then you have to click on the correct option. Children, you have to read the textbook very carefully. You have to go through all the lessons. Questions may be asked from the textbook. Okay, and now the paper pattern. Children, there are 4 questions. Okay, question number 1 will be choose and tick the correct option. Question number 2 will be check whether the statement is true or false and tick the correct option. Question number 3, solve the following problems in your book and tick the correct option. And question number 4 also same, solve the following problems in your book and tick the correct option. Now children, please note down that first of all the questions will be objective type questions. Okay, options will be given to you, you have to choose the correct option, right? Next is before starting your exam you have to be ready with a rough book or a rough page or a blank paper so that you can solve your questions in that book. Okay, and then you have to take on the correct option. Got it, children? Then next thing is questions will be asked from the textbook. So you have to go through the textbook carefully, everything. Okay, not only the sums, facts, everything you have to go through the lessons. So children, before your exam you have to be ready with your rough book, your pencil, your eraser, whatever is required, and then you are going to start your exam. Okay, whatever questions are there, if wherever required, you have to solve it in your rough book and then you have to choose the correct option. So children, now let us revise. We are going to start with the first question, which is choose and take the correct option. Let us begin with lesson number 1, numbers beyond 999. Now this type of questions are going to come for your exam. Okay, question number 1, dash comes before 567. There are 3 options given to us. We have to find the correct answer and then we have to tick the correct option. Now children, what comes before 567? What does that mean? Okay, now before number they have asked. A number one less than a given number comes just before it. It's called its predecessor or before number. That means 567 minus 1, which is equal to 566. Correct? So my correct option will be 566. So you have to tick on option number C. Now, question number 2, short form of 7000 plus 500 plus 10 plus 6 is dash. So children, here the expanded form is given. We have to write the short form, correct? Now, to write the short form of an expanded number, we write the face value. Okay, we have to find the face value of each number and then we have to write in the proper place. Now the question was 7000 plus 500 plus 10 plus 6. So now let us write the face value of each number, okay, in the proper place. So here ones place number 6 will come, in tens place number 1 will come, at hundreds place we will write 5, and at thousands place 7 will come. Correct. So we wrote here the face value. So that means the short form of 7000 plus 500 plus 10 plus 6 is 7516. So let us find the correct answer and we have to tick the correct option. Okay. Number 3. The place value of number 7 in 7893 is dash. Okay. So we have to find out the place value of the number 7. What is place value? The place value of a digit depends on its place or positioning of the number. Correct. Now we have to find the place value of number 7. Number 7 is in which place, children? Yes, it is in thousands place. So the place value of number 7 will be 7000. So we have to find the correct option and we will tick here. The C1, 7000 is the correct option. Next, question number 4. Put the correct sign. Okay. Now 9733-2478. There are three options given: greater than sign, less than sign, and equal to sign. Now children, for writing the correct answer or the sign, we have to compare the numbers. Okay. Now for comparison, you have to first compare the numbers. Now here you can see both of them are four digit number. So we will start comparing from thousands place. At thousands place, you can see the first number, we have number 9, and here we have number 2. Correct. So number 9 is greater than number 2. That means that 9733 is greater than 2478. So this sign will come, greater than sign. Okay children, so we will click on greater than sign. Next question is, the smallest 4 digit number that can be formed using the digit 5, 0, 3, 0 is, we have to find the correct answer. We have to find the smallest 4 digit number. Okay, we have to form a smallest 4 digit number. Now how to form a smallest 4 digit number, children? To form the smallest 4 digit number, arrange the given digits in ascending order. What is ascending? Smaller to bigger. Okay. So we have to find which is the smallest one out of this number? 0. But we cannot write 0 here. Why? Because we have to form smallest 4 digit number. If I write 0 in front, it doesn't have any value. So which is the next smallest number? Number 3. Okay, so first I will write number 3, then I will write the zeros. There are two zeros here, you can see both of them we have to write. Okay, it's a 4 digit number, and then the last digit will be number 5. So my answer is 3005. It is the smallest 4 digit number. So check where your correct option is and then tick on the correct option. Children, go slow, okay, and then check all the options. Next one is 300 more than 9645 is. Okay, now more than, when you hear the word more than, now more than means we have to add, correct? So that means 9645 plus 300. Okay. Now, after adding, we will get 5 plus 0 is 5, 4 plus 0 is 4, 6 plus 3 is 9, and 9. Okay. So, my correct option will be 9945. Children, in your rough this page, you have to do all the working, you have to solve it, and then you have to find the correct answer. Okay, tick on the correct option. Next question is, 100 less than 4521 is. Okay, now here, less than is our keyword. Okay, less than means we have to subtract, we have to take. So 4521 minus 100. Okay. So the working you are going to do it in your rough paper, and then you will find the correct answer. Now your 1 will come. 1 minus 0 is 1, 2 minus 0 is 2, 5 minus 1 is 4, and 4 will come at thousands place. So my correct answer is 4421. Okay, the C1 is the correct option. So click on the correct option. Now let us revise lesson number 2, Roman numerals. Children, in Roman numerals we have symbols and their values, correct? So we can say that Roman numerals is based on this 7 letters or alphabets, correct? So what are the symbols? I, V, X, L, C, D, M, and the values are I is equal to 1, V is equal to 5, X is equal to 10, L is equal to 50, C is equal to 100, D is equal to 500, and M is equal to 1000. The symbols and the values are very important so that you can write in Roman numerals. Children, first we are going to go through the rules. Okay, without the rules, we cannot write any number in Roman numerals, correct? So what are these rules? When a symbol is repeated, it means the value of each symbol is added. The sum is equal to the number formed, but any symbol cannot be repeated more than 3 times. Okay, now here you can see an example. The example will help you to understand. You can see here X and X. X means the value of X is 10, correct? So here I have written it 2 times. So when the same symbol is repeated, it means we have to add them. What we have to do? Add, correct? So here X is 10, the other X is also 10. 10 plus 10 is 20. So how do we write number 20 in Roman numerals? Like this. Okay, XX. Now also children, any symbol cannot be repeated more than 3 times, correct? So look at this example. Here we have X, X and X, okay, which is equal to 10 plus 10 plus 10, which is equal to 30. So 30 is written as X, X and X. The symbol I cannot repeat more than 3 times. Okay, so I cannot write X, X, X and X. Okay, it is wrong. It is not possible. Any symbol can be written only 3 times or only thrice. Got it, children? Second rule. When a smaller symbol or symbols are written after a larger one, then their values are added to get the number. Now, for example, here you can see XV. Children, X is a bigger value. After that, V is written. V is a smaller value. If the smaller value is written after the bigger one, what do? We add. Okay, it is added. X is 10, V is 5. So 10 plus 5 is 15. Got it? Now the next rule. The next rule is when the smaller symbol is written before the larger one, okay, then the values of the smaller symbol is subtracted from the value of the larger symbol. Children, look at this example, I, V. Okay, the smaller symbol is written first and then the larger one. Larger one is the V one. So what do? In that case, we subtract. Okay, so while subtraction, how we have to do the subtraction? 5 minus 1. V is 5 here and I is 1. 5 minus 1 is 4. So 4 is written in Roman numeral as IV. Okay. Here three options are given, we have to find the correct option. Children, I want you to solve all the questions, okay, and then find the correct answer and then choose it, okay. So we are going to solve it. 14. So 14, you expand it, okay. 10 plus 4. Now in Roman numeral, we don't have symbol for number 4, correct? We don't have symbol for number 4. So how 4 can be written? 4 can be written as 5 minus 1, correct? So this we have to do. In this manner, we have to solve the sum. So 10 is x, okay? 5 minus 1. As per the rule, if subtraction is given, the smaller number or the smaller value will come first. So I will come in between and V is 5. So V will come afterwards. So the answer is X, I, V. Then click on the correct option. Okay. Second one is X, V, I. In Hindu Arabic numeral system is written as. Okay. Now Roman numeral is given to us. We have to find out the Hindu Arabic system. Now, so you write down it and then replace it with each value. Now x is 10, correct? V is 5, then I is 1 and 1. We have to add because all of them are smaller. So 10 plus 5 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 18. So the value of x, v, I is 18. So we have your number 18 in our answer. We have to choose the correct answer. Take it. Okay. Next one is 25 is written in Roman numeral as. We have the options. Correct. So in a rough page, you are going to check what is 25. Now 25 is given, you are going to expand the number 20 plus 5. Now we don't have any symbol related to 20. So again we are going to expand it or you are going to divide it. How we can write number 20 in other ways? We can write as 10 plus 10. So we will write here 10 plus 10. Okay, because we know number 10 is X. One more number 10 will come, which is also X, and then number 5. 10 plus 10 is 20 plus 5 is 25. So 25 in Roman numeral is written as XXV. Okay. So here we have the option XXV. We are going to tick on that option. Children, now we are going to move towards lesson number 3, addition. Now, the first question is 658 plus 34. Okay, so for this we have to add. You can do this in your rough page. Okay, 658 plus 34, when we add, we will get the answer as 692. So we are going to click on the correct option. Then we will get more this type of questions. Okay, 1265 plus 303. Again, in your rough page, you write the question. You are going to add both the numbers and then you are going to find out the answer, which is 1568. So, do we have that option? Yes. So, we will take the correct option, which is 1568. Then, 2863. Rounded off to the nearest 1000 is. Now this is rounding off the numbers, correct? Now rounding off to nearest 1000, correct? The question is 2863. 2 is in thousands place. To round off this number, we have to look the number at hundreds place. At hundreds place, if it is 5 or more than 5, then what will happen? The number at ones place, tens place and hundreds place will become 0. And the number at thousands place, we have to add 1. So here, as it is more than 5, we will do 2 plus 1, which is 3. So after rounding off, we will get the answer as 3000. Correct. So here we have option number 3. option number C, which is 3000. So that is our correct answer. You have to tick on the correct option. Children, next from lesson number 4, subtraction. Here we are going to see a few important points. Okay. What is subtraction? Subtraction means taking away. It is also called a difference between two numbers, right? Now, when a number is subtracted from itself, the answer is 0. For example, 25 minus 25 is equal to 0, correct? The number when subtracted from itself is 0. When 0 is subtracted from a number, the answer is the number itself. What does it mean? It means that if I do 9 minus 0, what is my answer? My answer will be 9. Correct? So when 0 is subtracted from a number, the answer is the number itself. We cannot subtract a bigger number from a smaller number. Every addition has two subtraction facts and every subtraction has two addition facts. They both are related to each other. Then the bigger number from which the smaller number is subtracted is called the minuend, right? The smaller number which is subtracted is called the subtrahend and the result of the subtraction is called the difference. All the three terms are very important. Now children, let us solve few questions. 800 taken away from 7800 is, okay, we have to subtract. How we know we have to subtract? With the help of this keyword, which is taken away. Taken away means we have to subtract here. So in your rough paper, you are going to write the question 7800 minus 800. Solve and find out what your answer is. So after solving, you will get 7000, correct? So you are going to click on the correct option. Next one is 8150 minus 6050. Your direct subtraction they have given. So we have to write down the question and then we are going to solve it. Okay. So after solving, you will get the answer as 2100. Do we have 2100 in our option? Yes. So we are going to click on the correct option, which is 2100. Children, now I have few practice questions for you. You are going to note it down in your rough notebook and then you are going to solve it. Got it? So take out your rough notebook and start writing the questions. These questions are for your practice. Note it down, children. Try to find out the correct answer. Note down, children, all the questions, please. Write the options also, okay? And you are going to solve it in your rough notebook. Thank you, children. Please solve the practice questions in your rough notebook.